guys, welcome back to some more AFK Arena. Today we're over on the pay to win account and we are getting ready for the new hero. So within here we do have a brand new Dollys corner. Unfortunately, every time that I launch it in here, every time I launch it on my phone, it does just crash. So I'm not sure exactly what's going on with it. I know they're doing a lot of stability improvements. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna hop over to Reddit and we're gonna run through Dollys corner. All right guys, so here it is, volume 10 of Dollys Corner. Kind of crazy that we've already gotten 1,000 diamonds out of this. Thank you for all your sweet messages. You got me flustered. I'm surely grateful your attention and hard work can expect more of your love. Today I'll introduce you to one of the Noble Tavern's popular wines. That's right, so this is made from Thane himself, so very cool. Again, they put a lot of detail, they put a lot of content into this. That's a whole lot of exciting stuff coming up, so stay tuned for more. The Noble Tavern drink, so number 4, we've seen a couple of these before, so this is rye beer. It is from the Frozen Prairie alcohol beverage, 6 to 8%, so pretty strong there. Dwarves cannot live without this tipple, and enjoyed popularity. Star rating, it got 4 stars, so not too bad overall. So here it just runs through the ingredients, which is not too exciting. You got the Shepherd's Rye, the Crystal Mount Peaches, and then the menu item is a creamy butternut squash soup. If you guys have never had butternut squash soup, it is actually pretty good. It got 4 stars as well, and it is a little bit on the sweet side. Purple pumpkin, hexa bloom, and the knight's onion, as well as cow pie. So very interesting cow pie. Free range river dwelling amphibious cattle. So these are cows that live in the water, I guess. Are produced very sweet milk. Each eats lake algae and has a large diet. Less threatening than its calpine cousin, shrinks in size after producing milk. So very interesting to see exactly where they're going with this. Now this is what we've been waiting for, guys. Now Thane had a new beer, so Lightbearer Engraving sneak peek. So we know we already got the Wilder, Celestial, Hypogens, we got the Dimensionals. Now it is going to be the Lightbearers, guys, which is awesome to see this giant hammer. I'm a huge fan of Thor when he had Mjolnir. Very cool looking hammer indeed. So this is going to be one of the 2 or 3 bases for the Lightbearer faction when it comes to the engraving system. Now we're going to take a look at some of the Lightbearers within the engraving system or that are soon to come, and my thoughts on exactly what we're going to see out of the engraving system. So stay tuned for engraving of other faction and A Tale Has No Words. So this is the hero to come, which it looks like this is probably a hand, is what I'm imagining, is this would be a hand, and then here is a arm. So a giant mountainous creature. Makes me think either they're probably going to go Wilder. I would assume that it is going to be Wilder with a tank form rock giant, or it could be something possibly with the possibly within the Mauler faction. But I honestly think, with it being nature, you have the birds, you have the trees, you have kind of the water, and it looks like the flame down here. So I think this might be another arm, or this might actually be a leg going up to the body, but we'll have to see exactly what it looks like. This is going to be the next hero, guys. Looking at the time that we've had release since we've had Raku, we've already did Tae Lee, so they have done some Maulers, we've done some Graveborn. We've done Hodgkin and Graveborn. We've also done Morrow for the Lightbearers. So it is time for another hero to come out for the Wilders. I hope it is not a Celestial and a Hypogen, since we just got Zekas very shortly. We've gotten Leofric. We've gotten a significant amount of Celestials and Hypogen heroes. So I am calling this right now, and I am saying it is going to be Wilder, and it is going to be a tank or a warrior. Just looking at the dynamic here, I would absolutely say a tank. And the last page of this has the top secret number 8, the Faithful Dead. So as we see, guys, Thorin, absolutely cool to see. The backstories they do for this is really what a lot of players love. They really love the backstories for this game. He looks around 55 years old, so that could have been when he was deceased. In life, he focused was ruling the country and his only hobby. Since becoming Greyborn, he enjoys staining all he sees with the shadow of death. So he is just straight up evil. Present status, Graveborn King of King's Manes. Looking at the relationship, so Theowyn is the younger sister and Grez is his loyal subordinate. Not sure about Edwin. Edwin might be a hero that we see in lore, but it also could be a hero that we see later on, whether it's going to be the Lightbearer or if it's going to be undead. They could really play it either way. Looking at the lore they build for this game, very cool. And a lot of us seen this little trailer or this little comic. So there he is kind of fighting. After becoming king, the sister was sent away for marriage, which was Theowyn. The brother betrayed him, and finally, you are by my side, which is with Grez. So it looks like Edwin, the younger brother, did betray him and kill him. So if roughly Thorin's 55 years old, that means that his brother could still technically be alive since he was not killed, or if he has been killed. Going to be interesting to see exactly how they spin this story. And then here is Grez, the Munkineer. Looks around 28 years old, so relatively young. Training, stayed by the king's side, his royal highness, the king. So he is just all about the relationship that he has with the king and protecting the king. And then looking down here, of course, he is with Thorin. And interesting here, so there he is as a boy, to protect the king was his only goal. Finally, he protect the king, and even in death, his faithful is eternal to Thorin. So there he was alive. Once Thorin had died, I'm not sure exactly how Grez died or how he was killed. Not sure it says in here. To spend his life, couldn't be spent on Grez, train Ernest. Once he became Graveborn, so once he died, all his memories of staying by the king's side faded, and the desire to protect and serve the king became his only compulsion. So doesn't say how he died, but he is now kind of kin to or the disciple, the protector of Thorin. All right, guys, so let's take a quick look at the Lightbearer faction. We'll see exactly my thoughts on what's going on with the engraving that is coming. All right, so let's take a quick look, just running down kind of the Lightbearer heroes. I think this might be an easier way to do this. So Estrilda, we know, is focused on the Twisted Realm. They do still use her for Dark Nomura. But ultimately, going to be interesting because remember, these are the two skills, guys, the two bottom skills that do make a difference, that do get the adjustment within the engraving system. So they could make this Inspire ability even stronger, knowing that either it's going to boost attack or it's going to boost energy. So Estrilda is definitely one to look out for, as well as Ridicule. She doesn't do enough damage, especially AoE damage, so short of reducing the attack rating, but it's only 14%. Which is very, very low for the attack rating reduction. So plus 30 engraving on her might be one of their requirements. Belinda increasing the crit rating might have a purpose. The blessing would be interesting. Again, attack rating increased by 20%, crit rating increased by 20%. They could really make Belinda a key character if they focused on the engraving. Increasing the crit damage that she's doing. In addition, increasing the attack rating. So again, another one to really look out for. Rain with the lock-on ability, attack speed is increased by 30 points. If they let this be used on multiple allies, could be good. And that exploit, this is going to be interesting to see again at that plus 30, because allies' damage can be raised up to 30%. So not too bad there. Falks, the duration, so he might have a little bit more confine, which isn't going to make a difference. And then Silverbolt is not really going to make a difference either. Lucius, same with the Divine Blessing and with the Blessed Shield. As a tank, not going to make a very big difference. Thane could, if they buffed up his attack rating quite a bit. Focus is also pretty good with the crit rating because it kind of goes with his ultimate ability. Does well in the AE, but ultimately I think players are not going to build him. Hendrick, the same. When it comes to the tanking abilities, neither one of these seem like they're going to be super strong to really make a difference within the game. Now, Rowan could possibly make a difference depending on the health potion. With this healthy supplies, that's going to be one to see. If they do restore 40 and then the next one's restore 50, not going to make a big difference. Damage control could make a difference, guys. We know we utilize it to counter a lot of the high damage, like Athalia, the burst damage heroes. He can really pseudo tank super well, so definitely a hero to look out for. Gwen, I'm not sure if they're going to make her viable between these. The accuracy doesn't really seem to make that much of a difference. The crit rating, not that much of a difference. When she starts getting to late game, end game, she does drop off. So they really need to boost her damage to make her viable. If they fail to do that with the engraving system, not going to really make a difference. Now, Rose, Teacup, same thing, as well as Spring Cleaning, not going to make a difference, I believe, when it comes to the effectiveness of this. Again, not going to make a difference to build her. Now, Cecilia, again, could be viable if they made this damage higher. And then, of course, the Devil's Trap. It reduces the attack rating, but it's really not enough to make her super viable. Overall, I think it's not going to be that big. Rigby, the same. Damage is reduced, even if they add on to the damage reduction, even if they add on to the recovery rating, not going to make a difference for Rigby. Oscar, the same. I'm anticipating them to just add a little bit more damage, and then right here, a little bit more dodge and crit. Again, not really going to make a big difference. Lard could make a difference if this immunity lasts longer, because of his ability and kind of how he's built, if they do make this immunity last longer. And then this one, Judgment, not really going to make a big difference. When it comes to the overall damage, it doesn't really seem super effective to increase the damage. It's if they're adding more abilities, if they're adding such as Lyca with the Awe, like they did with Raku when they're adding the attack rating and the haste. That is what really makes a difference. Peggy, for her guards and her marksmen, again, not really going to make a difference. Same with Walker, the Gunslinger and the Old Faithful. Might do a touch more damage, but again, not going to be a difference. So Maro, this could be a difference if they do the Demonic Murmur doing a little bit more damage. But this is the interesting one. Maro deals damage. This ability can only target the same target every 4 seconds. So depending, again, on the damage that this puts out, could make a difference. But ultimately, he is just there for the crowd control aspect, which is why we built him, which is our very last Lightbearer, guys. So again, Astrilda, we could definitely watch. Belinda, Thane would be another one, depending where they put the damage or what they do with Gwen, and then Rowan as well. So just a couple to really watch in here. We'll see shortly. Since it's already been released in Dolly's Corner, we know it's not going to be too long before the Lightbearers are out on the test server. I looked today, there was nothing up. So probably within, I'd say, Wednesday, Thursday, we'll get the patch notes, and then we'll see exactly what we're getting with the Lightbearers. Right now, we do have the Wilders up, which we talked about just for a brief second. Lyca really making a difference, Raku making a difference. Rest of them, it's kind of build at your own leisure or at your own will. Not really making a difference short of those two within the Wilder faction. So we're going to have to see exactly what happens with our Lightbearers and what is going to make the difference. So guys, let me know in the comments what you guys think. And as always, thank you guys for watching.